Joseph Pear, also known as Lindsay, of Lafayette St. Andrew, former employee of Jonas Brown and Hubbard Limited, passed away on Saturday 9th September 2023 at the age of 82. He was the husband of Gladys Pear, father of Michael Henry, Jude Bubb and Henry Jones in Grenada, Esther Olive in the UK, Lucille James, Lucien Pear, Kenneth Pear, Gloria Romaine, Lindona Eartha Noel, and Sherry Connett in the USA. Grandfather of 29, great-grandfather of 27, brother of Geraldine Garrett and Teresa Williams, father-in-law of Leonie Henry, Alma Bubb, Chrisma Jones, Alexander James, Desmond Olive, Joseph Romaine, Kenneth Antwine, Sylvan Noel, and Roxanne Canterbury, brother-in-law of Teresa Myers in London and Lenora Wilson, uncle of many too numerous to mention. Many other relatives and friends, including the Marcel, Sherman, Chichester, and Charles families of Lafayette, the Alexis family of Mirabeau and in England, the Antwine family of Grenville, the James family of Happy Hill and Beaulieu, the Romaine family of Bonaire, the Noel family of St. Clouds, and friends and neighbors of Paradise and Lafayette. The funeral of the late Joseph Pear, also known as Lindsay, of Lafayette St. Andrew, will take place on Thursday, October 5th at 12:30 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the Grenville Roman Catholic Church, and entombment will be at the Grand Bra Cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Lynn Lowe of Ladigue St. Andrew, who resided in Connecticut, USA, died on Tuesday, 29th August 2023, at the age of 62. Left to mourn her husband Godwin Lowe in the USA. Children Janelle, Shawnell, Nazelle, Giselle, and Lyndon in the USA. Siblings Philip, Joseph in Canada, Franklin, Adrian, Joan, Ira, Sheila, and Stanley. 13 grandchildren, including Keturah and Junior in the USA, Kobe, Leisha, and Selena. 3 great-grands. Nieces and nephews, Julianne, Shirley, Reginald, Stacy, and many others. Sons-in-law, Wayne and Jelani George, Darion Mapp and Kevin Simon. 4 brothers-in-law, 3 sisters-in-law. Friends and family, Janice Griffith, Keturah Peterkin, the St. Louis family, the Wilshire family, the Paul family, the Best and Edwards families in the USA, and friends and family of Ladigue and in the USA. The funeral service for the late Lynn Lowe of Ladigue St. Andrew, who resided in Connecticut, USA, will take place on Thursday, October 5th at 1 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the Grenville Lighthouse Pentecostal Church, and interment will be at the Grand Bra Cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Bailey's Funeral Home.
James Alexander Joseph, also known as Mr. Thing and Mr. Clement of Corinth St. David, who resided at Bonnet St. Mark, passed away on Saturday, 23rd September, at the age of 89. He was the father of Jerry Joseph, Valin Young, also known as Valo, Peter Joseph in the USA, Hermy in Canada, Larry John, also known as Irie, Steve, Margaret, and Teresa Williams, also known as Little. Grandfather of many, including Maria Andrew, Kiara Joseph, Ariana Young, Nasha and Cindy Williams, Garfield and Dylan Wildman, great grandfather of many, father-in-law of Novely Barrington, Annie Young and Patricia Joseph, uncle of many, including Samuel Sylvester, Young Francis, Eric Agard, Joey and Joy. Many cousins, other relatives and close friends, including the Agard and Joseph families of Lasages and Corinth, the Bonaparte and Sylvester families of St. David, Mr. Frank and Wilma Sam, Ken Don, also known as Ben, geriatric caregivers, friends and neighbors of St. David, Victoria, Bonnet, and surrounding areas. The funeral service of the late James Alexander Joseph, also known as Mr. Ting and Mr. Clement of Corinth St. David, who resided at Bonnet St. Mark, will take place on Thursday, 5th October at 2 p.m. The funeral service will be held at the Victoria Bible Holiness Church St. Mark, and entombment will be at the Coast Guard Cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacroix Brothers Funeral Home.
Fitzroy Mason, also known as Sea Egg and Mace, of Caliste, who resided at Settlement Road, frequently St. George, former employee of Customs and Excise and a well-known shopkeeper, passed away on Friday, 22nd September 2023, at the age of 77. He was the husband of Lillian Alexander, father of Anderson Alexander, grandfather of Skye and Avery Alexander, father-in-law of Nikita Billy, brother of Ulrich, Frank, Thaddeus, Maureen and Carolyn Mason, Michael and Sonia Moore, and Gemma Phillip, uncle of many including Matthew Lewis, Shane, Anika, Kioma, Troy, Lyndon, and Lyndonna Mason. Many other relatives and close friends including Stanley Fraser, Michael Stewart, Michelle Samuel, the Brown, Roberts, Frederick, Mark, Billy, Smith and Reddit families, and friends and neighbors of Caliste, Frequenty and surrounding areas. The funeral of the late Fitzroy Mason, also known as Sea Egg and Mace, of Caliste, who resided at Settlement Road, Frequenty, St. George, will take place on Friday, October 6th at 1 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the Grand Arms Baptist Church, Maurice Bishop Highway, and interment will be at the Grand Arms Cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Beatrice Richards, also known as Clinthia and Miss B, of Mount Airy St. Paul's St. George, passed away on Wednesday, 20th September 2023, at the age of 69. She was the wife of Joel Richards, mother of Michelle Modeste, Patricia McNichols, Jason, Junius and Junil Richards, grandmother of Naya and Savian Mitchell and Keneal Bubb, sister of many including Michael, Johnny, Peter, Angus and Queen Anne Modeste, Gemma, Maria, Gleston, Lyon and Hazel, mother-in-law of William McNichols, Charles Mitchell, Kevin Budd and Gina Modeste, aunt of Tara Modeste, Abby, Catherine, Merliger, Kathisha, Jada and Jaden, godmother of Rye, many cousins, other relatives and close friends including the Richards family in St. Vincent, the Knights and Benoit families of St. Paul's, the Thomas family of Chantimel, the Alexander family, Avril, Gail, Christine, Aline Joseph, Glenna, and friends and neighbors of Mount Airy and surrounding areas. The funeral service for the late Beatrice Richards, also known as Clinthia and Miss B, of Mount Airy St. Paul's, will take place on Friday, October 6th at 1 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the St. Paul's Anglican Church, and interment will be at the Mount Airy Cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Lorraine Scott John, also known as Tanti Lorraine, Lolo and Gary Wright, of Marley St. Patrick, passed away on Wednesday, September 6th, 2023, at the age of 64. She was the mother of Thomas Jones, also known as Tito in the UK, and Gillian John in Grenada. Grandmother of Queen Anne, Azeda, Tiquani, Kimberly and Angel. Sister of Albert Jones, also known as Gang, May in the USA and Chris. Niece of Aaron, Zeltina, Wilma and Joycelyn. Aunt of three, godmother of many. Many other relatives and friends including Sherilyn, Joan, Eunice, Teacher Vic, Mr. Knights, Geraldine, Bamboo, Mrs. Francis, Keisha, Sybil, Petty, Sylvia, Mrs. Roseman, the Jones and John families of St. David, Gillian, Agnes, Yvette, Teacher Claudette, Nicole, Kiki, Charmaine, Xander, Farge, Spider, Trini, Lloyd, Bishop Harvey, Father Michael, Father Francis, Father Patrick, and parishioners of the St. Patrick's Catholic Church, Marilyn, the Maguire family, Mrs. Gordon, Hess, Marcia, Cheryl, friends at the Carib Shop, Cousin Robin, vendors at the Sotheby's Vegetable Market, Jobson, Paddy, Marissa Lett, members of the choir and charismatic prayer group, Carol's Choir, the SVP, staff of the Hilarion Home, staff of Royalton, the Ministry of Works, Minister Joseph Andel, the Honourable Deacon Mitchell and family, the Charles family, and friends and neighbours of Marley and surrounding areas. The funeral service for the late Lorraine Scott John, also known as Tanti Lorraine, Lolo and Gary Wright, of Marley St. Patrick, will take place on Monday, October 9th at 2 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the St. Patrick Catholic Church, Sutares, and interment will be at the Morley Cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lakwa Brothers Funeral Home. William Cadu, better known as Kim, of Windsor Forest, St. David, passed away on Wednesday, September 20th, 2023, at the age of 48, left to mourn are his mother, Louise Cadu, wife, Kimlin Victor Cadu, five children, Sean Kim, Shania and Shonji Cadu, Shonika Charles and Kimon Brown, 13 siblings, including Carol, Pecula, Dexter, Eugene, Brandon, Kerry, Junior and Shondi, one grandchild, Zaya Gilmore, one foster son, Tayshon Lucas, many aunts and uncles, including Catherine Cador, Glenna and Sharon Benjamin, many nieces and nephews, many close friends and relatives, including Norris Kilieston family of St. Andrew, the former staff of Singer Limited, Jane and Clement Thomas, Jamesy and the guys by the shop, the Dragon family of Windsor Forest, the Benjamin family of Guove, the Cadu family of Kumar, and neighbours and loved ones, other friends and relatives of Windsor Forest and surrounding areas, too numerous to mention. The funeral of the late William Cadu, better known as Kim, of Windsor Forest, St. David, will take place on Tuesday, October 10th at 1:30 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the Blessed Sacrament Church Grand Aunts, and interment will be at the Grand Aunt Cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Bailey's Funeral Home. Patrick Michael Telesford of Creighton St. George died on Saturday, September 16th, 2023, at the age of 94, left to mourn his beloved wife Elvira Telesford, children Lucille Copeland, Donna Jeremiah, Dennis, Frederick, and the Honorable Philip Telesford, one sister, 28 grandchildren, including Celine Samuel Dow, Arena and Jonathan Telesford, Jamie Jeremiah, and Camellia Hyacinth Nedfuka, 22 great-grands, including Neil Bernard, daughters-in-law Bernadette and Melinda Telesford, sons-in-law Joseph Copeland, Michael and Hyacinth Jeremiah, brother-in-law Joseph Elcock, many nieces and nephews in Grenada, the BVI, Trinidad, and the USA, including Margaret Richards, Pamela Caesar, Adriana Francis, Stephen and Judy Pivot, other close family and friends including the Pilgrim families of Springs, the Park, Griffith, Pivot, Braffitt and Bowen families of Montchaloo, and the Telesford families of Westerhall, Windsor Forest and Boca. The funeral service for the late Patrick Michael Telesford of Creighton St. George will take place on Tuesday, October 10th at 2 p.m., with tributes beginning at 1 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the People's Church St. Paul's, and entombment will be at the Montchaloo Cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Bailey's Funeral Home. Carlisle Francis Paul, also known as Brother Lou, of Coles Gap St. David, a former bus driver, passed away on Friday, 22nd September 2023, at the age of 72. He was the husband of Anne Spann, also known as Rosalind Spann Paul, father of Magdalene and Natalie Hazard, Jesslyn George, also known as Givon, Rodney and Fayula Frederick, Maudeen, Paulian Calist, Carlin Spann Simeon, Claude, Connie, Karim, Shari and Carrie Spann, Jason Lyons, Andy Gilchrist, Nakangi Stapleton, Chris and Christelle Rennie, and Kellon. Stepfather of Michael Spann, grandfather of 39, including Ronica Cornwall, Rishon Peters, Levi Frederick, Cornaya and Cormaya, Kyla Spann, Victor Kingston, Trisha Hazard, Richelle Spann, and Kalisha Welch. Great grandfather of 3, brother of Denroy, Alwyn, Christopher, Cheryl, and Cletus Collins. Uncle of many, including Leslie Ann, Kalisha, and Tracy Paul. Nephew of many, including Miralda Paul, Camilla Collins, and Mike Smith. Father-in-law of many, including Roxanne Frederick, Aja Bowen, and Tricia Williams. Brother-in-law of many, including Kathleen Collins, Rachel, and Shamanda in the USA. Close friend of June Rathead and Roger. Many other relatives and friends, including the Collins, Paul, John, Spann, and Thomas families of Coles Gap, members of the Grand Anse Bus Association, and friends and neighbours of Coles Gap and surrounding areas. The funeral of the late Carlisle Francis Paul, also known as Brother Lou, of Coles Gap St. David, will take place on Tuesday, October 10th at 1 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the Children of the Light Spiritual Baptist Church, Lassiter St. David, and interment will be at the Corinth Cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home.
When a loved one passes on, we all need the comfort, support, and guidance of a trusted friend. You can rely on Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. We provide a personalized professional service that exceeds all expectations. Our dedicated staff responds to your every need with the greatest detail, ensuring affordability with a variety of options. Our upgraded state-of-the-art facilities, spacious air-conditioned chapel with live internet streaming, a modern, environmentally safe crematorium, the only of its kind on island, private viewing spaces, large on-site repair center, a modern transportation fleet. Join our burial society today and make personalized arrangements for that final moment. As you prepare to enter your loved one into eternal rest, visit or call Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home and select a package that brings added comfort to the entire family. Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home and Burial Society, continuing a tradition of excellence.
Rupert Ethelbert Link, of Lamode and St. George's Estate, St. George, who resided in the USA, passed away on Thursday, September 14th, 2023, at the age of 89. He was the father of Irva Cyrus and Ansel Thomas Clovis, grandfather of Jacinta Cyrus Penny, Unet Horn, Cherise Brown, and Cheryl Jones, great-grandfather of 10, brother of Lucy Cadore, Linda Hippolyte, also known as Rosalind, Donna Link Scott, and Mark and Martin Lawrence. Several nieces, nephews, cousins, other relatives and close friends, including the Lawrence, Link, Atts, Johnson, Fraser and Noel families, the Donald, Purcell, Aben, Dolland, Edgehill, Butler, Stewart, Harris, Botus and Nixon families, and friends and neighbours of Lamode and St. George's Estate and surrounding areas. The funeral service for the late Rupert Ethelbert Link of Lamode and St. George's Estate, St. George, who resided in the USA, will take place on Wednesday, October 11th at 1 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the Beaulieu Roman Catholic Church, and entombment will be at the Beaulieu Cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Gladys Simon née Campbell, also known as Miss Gladys or Simon, of Cornets Walk, Wharf, St. John, passed away on Saturday, September 9th, 2023, at the age of 99. She was the mother of Ramos and Rena Ann in the USA and Fillmore, grandmother of 10, including Carl, also known as Sotty, Nathaniel, Sarah, Jason and Garvin in Canada, Shania and Rhea in the USA, great-grandmother of 2, aunt and grand-aunt of many, caregivers Ina, Judy and Pam, many cousins, other relatives and close friends including the Campbell, Simon, Alphonse and Mitchell families, Jane Ellen and the Glaze family in England, the St. John's Anglican School staff, and friends and neighbours of Wharf and surrounding areas. The funeral service for the late Gladys Simon née Campbell, also known as Miss Gladys or Simon, of Cornets Walk, Wharf, St. John, will take place on Wednesday, October 11th at 1 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the St. John's Anglican Church and interment will be at the Churchyard Cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Camillus Nimrod Henry, also known as Big Joe and Folk Dance, of Birchgrove St. Andrew, proprietor of Henry's Brokerage Clearance Services and treasurer of the Birchgrove Development Council, passed away on Monday, 4th September 2023 at the age of 43. He was the father of Neshona Henry, son of Orion and Sherma Henry, grandson of Bernadine Henry, also known as Miss Little, brother of Cadella Henry Victor, Camille Henry Billy, Cordelia and Canida Henry, brother-in-law of Horace Chetty Victor and Shadrach Billy, nephew of Mona Walden, Cyril Henry, Tony Boris Henry, Hankshire Matthew, Christine Hutchinson, Marcia Henry, Ivan and Kelly Matthew, and Pastor Leo Prince, grandnephew of Mrs. Bernadette Beckles and teacher Myra Gabriel, uncle of Chelsea and Chelone Victor, Cameron Henry Charles, and Shadia Billy. Many cousins are the relatives and friends in Grenada, Canada, the USA, and the UK, including Christabel Noel, Siobhan McIntyre, Roland Rennick and family, Sherman Thomas, Dixon Frank, Sheldon and Derek Joseph, Warren Powlett and Michelle Bernard, the 1997 graduating class of the Presentation Brothers College, clients of Henry's Brokerage Clearance Services, the management and staff of George F. Huggins, the Mitchell family of Richmond, Marcus and Marcia Gabriel and family, the Henry, Matthew, Charles, Campbell, Beggs and McSween families, friends on the block at St. James, Birchgrove, Monlong and surrounding areas. The funeral of the late Camillus Nimrod Henry, also known as Big Joe and Folk Dance, of Birchgrove St. Andrew, will take place on Wednesday, 11th October at 1 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the St. Matthew's Catholic Church, Birchgrove, and interment will be at the St. Rose Cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Dennis Albert Dragon, also known as Cock, of La Femme St. David, who resided at Confer Calivany St. George, passed away on Saturday, 16 September 2023, at the age of 74. He was the father of Indra in the USA, Raymond and Kim in Canada, Anika and Keon in Grenada, grandfather of 13, including Jeremy and Opemi in the USA, Anaya, Amaya, and Ariana, brother of Julian, Adrian, Derek, Brenda and Celia, father-in-law of 3, including Dr. Adenia, many nieces and nephews, many other relatives and friends, including the Joseph family of Latant, the Mitchell family of Mount Airy, the Cador family of St. Paul's, Margaret of Labury, and friends and neighbors of La Femme, St. Paul's, Confer, and surrounding areas. The funeral of the late Dennis Albert Dragon, also known as Cock, of La Femme St. David, who resided at Confer Calivany St. George, will take place on Friday, October 13th at 1 p.m. Funeral service will be held at the Garden of Remembrance Funeral Chapel, Cemetery Hill St. George's, and interment will be at the Wilberforce Cemetery. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Eileen Alexis of Archibald Avenue St. George died on Sunday, October 1st, 2023. At the age of 102. The funeral arrangements for the late Eileen Alexis of Archibald Avenue St. George will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Bailey's Funeral Home. Agnes Cynthia Hippolyte, also known as Auntie Cynthy of Bellevue St. David, passed away on Friday, 29th September 2023, at the age of 86. The funeral arrangements for the late Agnes Cynthia Hippolyte, also known as Auntie Cynthia of Bellevue St. David, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Anthony Mahorn, also known as Curry of Corinth St. David, died on Saturday, September 30th, 2023, at the age of 57. The funeral arrangements for the late Anthony Mahorn, also known as Curry, of Corinth St. David, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Bailey's Funeral Home. Archbishop Veronica Hines, also known as Mother Hines and Vero, of Spring St. George, passed away on Wednesday, 27th September 2023, at the age of 87. The funeral arrangements for the late Archbishop Veronica Hines, also known as Mother Hines and Vero, of Spring St. George, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacqua Brothers Funeral Home. Ina Hilda Lewis, also known as Liz, of Victoria St. Mark, who resided at Crowshew St. Andrew, passed away on Monday, 18th September 2023, at the age of 93. The funeral arrangements for the late Ina Hilda Lewis, also known as Liz, of Victoria St. Mark, who resided at Crowshew St. Andrew, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacroix Brothers Funeral Home. Mary Virginia Francois, also known as Olive Alexander and I.E., of Mount Craven St. Patrick, passed away on Tuesday, September 5th, 2023, at the age of 90. The funeral arrangements for the late Mary Virginia Francois, also known as Olive Alexander and I.E., of Mount Craven St. Patrick, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacroix Brothers Funeral Home. Veronica Frank, also known as Tarn Vero of Victoria St. Mark, who resided at Vendom St. George and in Canada, passed away on Monday 25th September 2023 at the age of 88. The funeral arrangements for the late Veronica Frank, also known as Tarn Vero of Victoria St. Mark, who resided at Vendom St. George and in Canada, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacroix Brothers Funeral Home. Alethea Myrtle Jean Thompson, also known as Auntie Jean of Rosehill St. Patrick, passed away on Saturday 23rd September 2023 at the age of 93. The funeral arrangements for the late Alethea Myrtle Jean Thompson, also known as Auntie Jean of Rosehill St. Patrick, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacroix Brothers Funeral Home. Gemma Antoine Wilson of Guave St. John, who resided at Bonaire St. Mark, a distinguished and much-loved mathematics and Bible knowledge teacher and former deputy head teacher of the St. Mark Secondary School, passed away on Monday 28th August 2023 at the age of 67. The funeral arrangements for the late Gemma Antoine Wilson of Guave St. John, who resided at Bonaire St. Mark, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacroix Brothers Funeral Home. Elsie Ferguson, MBE, also known as Teacher Elsa and Elsie, of Guave St. John, who resided at Woburn St. George, died on Thursday, September 14, 2023, in Tobago, at the age of 75. The funeral arrangements for the late Elsie Ferguson, MBE, also known as Teacher Elsa and Elsie, of Guave St. John, who resided at Woburn St. George, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Bailey's Funeral Home. Teresa Antwine, also known as Cooley, of Central Guave Estate St. John, who resided in Canada, passed away on Wednesday, 23rd August 2023. At the age of 59. The funeral arrangements for the late Teresa Antwine, also known as Cooley, of Central Guave Estate St. John, who resided in Canada, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacroix Brothers Funeral Home. Roxanne Jason Marshall, also known as Rox, of Guave St. John, passed away on Thursday, 14th September 2023, at the age of 47. The funeral arrangements for the late Roxanne Jason Marshall, also known as Rox, of Guave St. John, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacroix Brothers Funeral Home. Jean Agnes Bartholomew of New Hampshire St. George passed away on Wednesday, 13 September 2023, at the age of 71. The funeral arrangements for the late Jean Agnes Bartholomew of New Hampshire St. George will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Bailey's Funeral Home. Reverend George Milton Guy, also known as Gapman, of Lauriston Carrieacoo, passed away on Tuesday, September 12, 2023, at the age of 68. The funeral arrangements for the late Reverend George Milton Guy, also known as Gapman, of Lauriston Carrieacoo, will be given in a subsequent broadcast. Funeral arrangements entrusted to Lacroix Brothers Funeral Home. In loving memory of Fitzroy Bernard Boatswain of Happy Hill, who resided at Beausejou St. George, and passed away on Thursday, 29th September 2022, and was entombed on Tuesday, November 8, 2022. God knew that you were suffering. He knew you were in pain. He saw the road was getting rough, and the hills were hard to climb. So he closed your eyes and whispered, "Peace be thine." It broke our hearts to lose you, but you did not go alone. A part of us went with you the day God took you home. Remembering you is their mother, Elmina, brothers, sisters, nieces, nephews, other relatives and friends. May your soul rest in peace. Funeral arrangements were entrusted to Bailey's Funeral Home.
The management and staff of MTV extend deepest condolences to those of you whose loved ones have passed on. Thank you for watching.
John 14:13, blessed is the dead that die in the Lord. If your loved one died in the Lord, you have nothing to worry about. You could be confident that one is in a better place. But what about you who are left behind to mourn? What if you had been called? Were you ready? If you are not ready, you can be ready while you are alive. The word of God says, it's appointed unto man once to die, but after this is the judgment. So you can live, and after death, you're going to live forever. You would not be disintegrated into nothing. You would be living forever. So while you're alive, is the time to be ready to meet the Lord. I would like to encourage you to give your life to the Lord Jesus Christ while you are still on the earth. There is no repentance after death. The time is now. The Lord Jesus Christ gave his life on the cross so that you can have life. And while you are living, is the time to make it right with the Lord. Jonah said in Jonah 4:3, yeah, it is better to die than to live. So the dead should be happy if they die in the Lord. If you are not sure that you are ready, if your time comes, you can be ready. You can be ready even at this very moment. If you'd only open your heart to receive the Lord Jesus Christ and pray this simple prayer, just say, "Lord Jesus, I am sad because my loved one has gone, but I am left behind and I want to be ready when my time comes. So I'm asking you to forgive me for my sins. I'm asking you to give me eternal life. Forgive me, cleanse me from all unrighteousness, and save me so that when my time comes, I can live with you. I trust that you meant what you said. I trust that you believe the word of God." And as we end this program for you, with you, encouraging you, strengthening you in your time of sorrow, your preparation for your time should be now. God bless you, and see you next time. Amen.